Back in the very high heat of August, we conducted an experiment with CCI's 40 grain segmented subsonic round to see if it would hold the same ballistics trajectory as its non-segmented brother. Well, it was so hot and humid back then that we really did not get the greatest experiment that we could have had. Today, it's January. The temperature is at least 40 degrees lower, and we're about to re-perform that experiment. That's coming up next on Mostly 22LR. Hey everybody, Rob Rosenberger here for Mostly 22LR. It's about 55 degrees and sunny with light cloud cover. The wind is coming in at about 3 to 5 miles an hour, which is beautiful, and those cicadas that were yelling at us back in August, they all died after having sex. So we're going to re-perform our experiment, shooting CCI 0074, a segmented subsonic 40 grain hollow point, to see if its ballistics trajectory matches CCI's 0056, its non-segmented counterpart. Again, this is a continuation of the tests that we've been doing on these two rounds. In our previous attempt in August, we shot a single 20-round group of CCI 0056, followed by a single 20-round group of CCI 0074. Today, we're going to shoot 30-round groups, except we're going to switch up the ammo every 10 rounds. Okay, so we're back in the RV after another great day of shooting. It's actually a day after the targets that we shot at 200 yards. I want to stop here and I want to give an unsolicited plug for the folks at cwpsumpter.com. These folks don't even charge me money to use that range one Saturday a month. They don't even ask me to plug them on YouTube, which is just great. They're just happy to let me borrow the range. So if you need a concealed weapons permit course in the state of South Carolina, please check them out. And if you take the course from them, come on by range 2 when you've got a moment. I promise you we'll hang out on video and woo, and we'll say hi to YouTube. So, and tell them I said, and tell the folks at CWP Sumter that I sent you. I really want them to know that they're getting some benefit from the 200-yard range that they're letting me borrow. The targets tell the tale. Forget this qualified yes that I gave you back in August. This is a definite yes. If you shoot CCI 0056, if that's what you zero your rifle with, you can arbitrarily put a 0074 into your chamber and pull the trigger. You're going to hit your mark all the way out to 200 yards. The targets tell the tale. I am stunned by this. This is a testimonial to CCI. Now, CCI only claims this kind of ballistics trajectory out to 100 yards, that 7.4 will match 5.6. I'm telling you, it goes out to 200 yards. When I sat down after the initial analysis yesterday, I sat down tonight, I did my circles with my protractors, I found where my XY00 is, and between 0056 and 0074, the geometric centers are only off by a half MOA. Half MOA at 200 yards. That's well within the specifications for the Marlin XT22 RZ that I'm using. And also, that's a testament to the XT22, that whole series of rifles from Marlin. Marlin, I really congratulate you on coming out with a $200 rifle that does this well. So there's nothing special that I've done to this rifle other than to put a plus 25 MOA cant on the Picatinny rail and to put a Mueller 25 power scope on it. Other than that, it's the DFT lead sled and the guy behind the trigger. So, I mean, I was on my A game. The weather was perfect, as you heard. Just fantastic. Now, I did have one flyer on 0056. And I don't know what happened there, just one flyer. And I came up with the numbers, which you see. The photos have already rolled. You can always go back and take a look at the photos to see what the data is. I declared three flyers, two flyers plus an alibi on 0074. I did have an alibi. One of my shots, I ended up shooting inside a heartbeat instead of between heartbeats. So I'm not sure which shot that was, but I declared one to be off. So I pulled a flyer out for that. And since I had pulled a flyer from 0056. I felt that it was okay to pull one flyer out. There was a flyer right next to it. So I said, okay, there's three flyers, alibis, whatever you want to call them. And when I put it all together, I came up with my 00. Fantastic. Absolutely. Half an MOA. I'm still stunned. I look at these and I'm like, wow, I'm like nutting fancy when I look at these targets. I'm absolutely stunned by what I see here. I think we're done with the tests with between 0074 and 0056. We've done the tests with the jugs out to 200 yards. We know that 0056 is not really an ammo you would want to use against larger game like piglet, shote, coyote. But 0074 remains a devastating round out to 200 yards, at least according to the jugs that we've taken. I think also that 0074 is a fantastic round in terms of being able... This is a money thing that I want to talk about. Right at the moment, watching some of the gun shops and the advertisements and AmmoSeek.com, 0056 right now is going for about 20 cents a round. It should be going for 7 cents a round, but it's going for 20. And 0074, which is segmented, should be going for about 12 cents a round at most. It's going for 35 cents a round. If you were to shoot 0056 for small game at close distances, you could just arbitrarily switch over to the more expensive stuff, 0074, and take your longer distance shots or take larger game with it, if you will. I think that's the right way to go economically. Now, me... I do have some 0056. I still have, let's call it plenty if I were to hunt. So I would be able to put 0056 into my chamber. I would zero with it, which I do. That's my plinking ammo. And then if I ever needed to take out a coyote or a shote or a piglet at 200 yards, I wouldn't be afraid with the rifle that I shot to take those shots. So you've seen the photos again. Now at the end of this video, I'm going to roll my initial analysis out in the field yesterday. You don't have to watch it if you don't want to. It's right after the credits roll. But you'll see, even out in the field, when I make a couple of, I'm just doing some quick math and some quick circles with some silver markers. And I told you out in the field yesterday, not knowing how close these really were, I still had, this is a definite yes. I was just so happy with these targets. So, big shout out to CCI. How you got a copper-clad segmented bullet to have the same ballistics trajectory as a non-copper-clad, non-segmented bullet, I don't know, but whoever did that is a beautiful engineer on bullets, so ballistics, kudos to them. Marlin, that XT-22 performed beautifully. Look at those targets. At 200 yards, using, essentially cheap ammo, I'm popping 4 MOA on CCI 0056, and I'm popping between 3.6 and 3.6 and 2.1 MOA with 0074. 2.1 MOA on the horizontal. It's on the horizontal. 2.1 MOA on the horizontal on an XT-22 that I paid $237 for. So, Marlin, when people say, oh, your guns suck, you tell them to go look at mostly 22LR. All right, so we're done with the experiments with 0074 versus 0056, unless somebody can come up. If you've got an idea for those two to put another experiment, leave a comment in the section, in the comments below, and let me know. I'm always happy. I've got a few more rounds of 0074 and 0056, so we can continue to do more tests if necessary. If I could ever find a 300-yard range, I might be tempted to do 300 yards, but 200, I think, is about the maximum that a lot of people are going to be doing for the two rounds that we're talking about. So, again, remember, at the end of the credits, when the credits roll, the initial analysis is out there, but you don't need to see it. I'm Rob Rosenberger for mostly 22LR. And remember, 22LR is real ammunition. Treat it as such. Okay, so the day's shooting is over. I really want to give a big shout out to the folks at cwpsumter.com. They're the folks that let me use this 200-yard range one Saturday every month. If you need a concealed weapons permit in the state of South Carolina, I hope you'll check out cwpsumter.com. And if you come down here to shoot, you're probably going to see me out here shooting a YouTube video as well. I want to start with the sight-in targets right here using CCI 0056. This is my initial sight-in target, and I noticed when I was shooting that from the time from the high heat of summer until now, I was about 3 inches low and about 2 inches to the left. I made my corrections on my Mueller 8-25 scope and came in really, really well. All of these shots that you see right here are within the green. I then went ahead and scrubbed the bore with a dry nylon brush and then brushed the bore out with two cotton patches and then began my shots. Now, the reason I wanted to do two 30-round groups, one and two, but shooting 10 rounds each ammo and switching targets is because I wanted to see after the first 10 targets what these bad boys were starting to look like in case there was any problem that I needed to correct along the way. I didn't have to. These right here were doing fantastic. They were a little bit high and to the right, and I was a little bit concerned about that, but it is what it is. It's possible that by scrubbing the bore and then patching it, that I changed the characteristics of the rifle barrel. However, it did settle down a little bit, and as you can see right here, all 30 shots are accounted for on CCI 0056. All 30 shots are accounted for here on 0074. Now, the CCI 0056 is about 2 inches high and about 1.5 inches to the right. At least it looks like there. I'll do some more analysis when I get back to my place. And here, it's almost perfectly level, and it's about 3 inches to the right. What that means is, if you do the math real quick, you know that it's about, CCI 0056 is about one MOA higher than CCI 0074, and it's about 0.75 MOA to the left of CCI 0074. So what this tells me is that this is less than one MOA of difference between the two rounds at 200 yards, which is well within the specifications for a Marlin XT22 RZ with no suppressors on board. So what I'm going to say, no more qualified yes. We're going to go with a confident yes that if you shoot and zero your rifle with CCI 0056, you can arbitrarily put in CCI 0074 and expect your shot to land in the same place. Now, that's a useful thing to know if you're hunting at 200 yards on larger targets like coyote or piglets or shotes. This is an easy way for you to get stuff out there. Now, at 200 yards, having watched the jugs and analyzed the water jugs, I'm not really confident in sending a round downrange to shoot at a piglet or at a coyote. But CCI 0074, I really do believe, is the good round to use, even out to 200 yards. You can take an ethical shot, as long as you're shooting a blush shot, brain, lungs, spine, heart, and you could arbitrarily use the cheap stuff to sight in and then use the expensive stuff to go hunting. That's an amazing statement to say about basically inexpensive CCI ammo versus the more expensive segmented rounds. So what have we learned today? We've learned simply that if you're shooting CCI 0056 all the way at the 200 yards, you can just arbitrarily put in CCI 0074 and know that you're going to hit your mark. I'm Rob Rosenberger for Mostly 22LR. And remember, 22LR is real ammunition. Treat it as such.